sweet, sweet memories you gave of me. You can't beat the memories you gave of me.
If I remember rightly, the girls used to sit on the left-hand side of the class as we faced the blackboard, and you're in single desks in rows going back.
Yeah.
Yeah? Uh-huh. And the boys were usually on the right-hand side. That's the way the seating was set up. And we had these desks with a lid on, ink pot on the right-hand side. And there used to be ink in them at one point when I first started there. And, of course, it was a real mess because I'm left-handed. So every time I went in the ink pot, I blotted the book.
Uh-huh.
You know, it was so I used to sit sideways like that in the desk to get it over. And then I was told to sit straight.
Uh-huh.
You know, there was no consideration of being left-handed.
How did you get to school? Because you came from Saddleworth, David. I'm assuming that involved like several buses, did it?
Well, fortunately, there was what they call a workers' bus that came from Newey, and it came right through to Stamford Square. There was a regular bus service from Upper Mill to Stamford Square, but I could get on one bus and get there. But with having asthma, and it was a single-decker, and I used to absolutely crease me. Getting in that single decker, and every worker probably smoked, didn't they? And they just, I used to get up to pay, and I could feel my chest tightening, you know. It was,
in those days,
you didn't have anything for asthma.
No.
Later on in life, I used to get, I used to come home on top mostly by school, you know, one from the main on Ashton Road, Mosley Road. Uh-huh. Mosley, and then one from Mosley, you know, up to home. But at the about when I was about 15, I started coming on the train. But it was touch and go whether I made it in time for the start of school.
Uh-huh. And did you walk? Did you used to walk then, Peter, from Ashton Moss?
I would do. an admission. What I started doing, it used to be a penny on the bus, the number 5 down into Ashton. And then you'd go round past Henry Moon's and catch the bus that went up to Ashton Grammar School. And it was a penny on each trip. And a woodbine from Noel's shop on at the top of Mosley Road there was tuppence. So if you walk through, you could have a fag, you know. It was...
Uh-huh. Was there a bike shed to go behind in those days then at the school?
Yeah, there was. Now, later on, when I got... You couldn't go on a bike. You had to get a place in the bike shed before you could go on your bike. And it was usually when you got to about the third form that you could go on a bike. So I got a place in the bike shed and then started going to school, you know, on the bike, which was much better. And it was also useful as well, because instead of staying for school dinners, which were awful, we used to go home. In those days, you know, we used to get these stringy chops and awful pieces of meat, all supplied by Louis Edwards, who used to own
Manchester United
Football Club.
Oh, yeah.
And that's where it all came from. But when I started going home for school dinners, and I used to stop off. There was is it Curzon Road that's just down from...
Since
I left Ashton. Used to be a baker's shop. It had a Turog sign over the front of it, if I remember. And I used to buy day-old pies and things and take them into school through the back gate and buy these things a penny a piece and sell them for tuppence to all the kids who were hanging around waiting for me to come in with penny loaves and meat and potato pies and meat pies.
Yeah.
So it was, made the odd tuppence a threatens doing that sort of trip.
Well, that would have kept you.
Entrepreneur starting up.
That would have kept you in Woodbines.
It would. It did.
I mean, those penny loaves, when they were hot, were lovely, weren't they?
Oh, they were gorgeous. Yeah.
But I used to go down when I was about 14. I hated school dinners because I didn't eat meat or fish or egg. You know, so I have a very limited diet. But school meals were horrible. And I started playing snooker when I was 14, and I used to go down to the Pillow in Ashton, which was next to the fire station.
Oh, yes.
Down during my dinner hour. And there was, a restaurant stroke cafe. I think it was called Booth, but I could be wrong. It was round near the market, I think. And I used to go in there and just get a cheese and onion pie and nipping yeah. away a couple of frames of snooker, you know. Sometimes I didn't get back to school, you know.
So what? I mean, both of you have mentioned the school dinners were awful. What was so bad? Was there a canteen or something? We had there was a canteen when we were there.
They used to if you had lamb chops and there'd be in a big dish served to the table. There'd be eight of you on and one person had to serve it up.
That's right, yeah.
And these things were floating in fat and grease. And they, you know, they'd not been grilled, they'd been stewed. It was awful. Occasionally there was something good, you know, like a steam pudding or whatever. But a lot of things like rice pudding and semolina, you know, the frog spawn.
Oh,
dreadful.
Horrible.
What
was PE like in those days?
He was called Jeremy something or other, the PE bloke. He was an ex army or RAF PI, and they were bastards, a bit awful. They were horrible, the PE teachers, weren't they? They were bullies, you know, and especially, you know, I mean, we used to do a cross-country run from the school up to Arthur Pike, and you used to start off going on to the Stamford Park and setting up there, you know. And Alvin used to hide off in the bushes, you know, in the rhododendron bushes, you know, till it came back. You know.
And I remember one chap had turned up without his, he'd forgotten his pumps.
He
gave him a good hiding. You know, I mean, put him across his knee and gave him a right good hiding. I couldn't believe it. you know, the violence that went on from the teachers was unbelievable in those days.
Really?
Bad, John. And the cap. My cap came with a metal badge that was pinned on it. And you went into school and you hung your coat up and your cap because that's what I'd done at junior school. And when I came back, my cap and badge had been nicked. My raincoat was still there. But, first day, lost a new cap.
The school caps, I mean, everybody used to have them on the back of the eddy bench. And the older you got, the further they went back. But the girls... hats were shocking, weren't they? The big nebs on, like, the jockeys' caps, weren't they? They were atrocious, you know?
Yeah, yeah. And in summer, they used to wear gingham dresses, didn't they?
They did, blue and white,
I remember...
Just a little tale about Cain in here. I mean, it was no deterrent, really. In fact, the more Cain you had, the more of a bit of a hero you were, like, you know? Mm-hmm. But the day before we actually finished, we all had... all the fellow lads that agreed would come dressed teddy boyish.
Oh, okay.
Now, I always wore these beetle crushes or, you know, brothel creepers, whatever you want to call it. But I came in some red and black striped drainpipe jeans. And another lad called Kitty Armitage, which came in like a Saks blue cardigan, wasn't they, teddy boyish? But they sort of picked me up and dragged me and Kitty into the assembly, you know, and I was in an uproar, you know. Anyway, Willie Wood, the deputy head and my art teacher, came and dragged us out and stood us in front of Hopkinson's door. He came out to take assembly and he looked at Armitage and he said, "You live locally, don't you?" He said, "Right, you go home. You wait there, sure." So I had to wait while he came back. So I went in and he said, "I'm a good man to give you a good hiding, sure." He said, "But seeing it's your last day at school, you come dressed like a labourer, you can go and work like a labourer." So I had to work with Rocky Groves all day, putting goalposts up outside, cheering out of the windows, you know. So, I mean, it was quite often, it was quite a regular thing, caning, wasn't it? It was certainly what in our day. But I don't remember a girl being caned, you know.
No, I don't.
Was Miss Greenwood there when you were there then?
Oh, yes.
Miss Greenwood.
It's great.
She was lovely for him, every island, you know.
She was. Yeah, I went to a funeral.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's what I thought about her. I thought she was wonderful.
Yeah, she did.
Sweet, sweet memories you gave of me. You can't beat the memories you gave of me.